pie chart at all. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما، نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وسلم، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد، كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين وعترة نبيك الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ألم تر كيف ضرب الله مثلا كلمة طيبة كشجرة طيبة أصلها ثابت وفرعها في السماء تؤتي أكلها كل حين بإذن ربها ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس لعلهم يتذكرون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. One of the most important teachings of Islam that has been mentioned in the Quran and the Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and our Imams is that we beautify our speech with people. We sweeten it. We make it beautiful. We improve our speech. God says in the Quran, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Speak kindly, speak nicely, speak humbly with people. Even science today have discovered, and some research finds, that when you speak nicely to people, you use beautiful words, kind words with people, it will impact their brain. It will positively impact people's brain. And on the other side, if someone is being discourteous, rude, harsh, impolite, again his or her words are going to negatively impact the brain, and some of the cells in the brain are going to die because they get wounded, they get hurt. This is a scientific research. They suffer, some of the cells in the brain are going to suffer because of this emotional damage, emotional offense, they're going to die. And also it will cause disturbance in people's feelings and thinking. And as a result of that, the study says, a wounded person who has been put down, insulted, humiliated, would suffer emotional pain, and a constant feeling of frustration, negative feelings. And sometimes these statements come, these harsh words come from family members, not necessarily an outsider or stranger. Sometimes it takes place by a father, who constantly puts his children down, always chiding them, criticizing them, blaming them, pointing his finger at them. At the especially time of anger, we lose our senses. We lose our senses. The person comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he says to him, "O Messenger of God, Evni, advise me." The Prophet says, "La taghdab, don't get angry." He says, "What again? Give me another advice." The Prophet repeats the same one, "Don't get angry." He says, "What else?" The Prophet says for the third time, "Don't get angry." Anger is the key for every destruction, every frustration. Try to avoid it. It's hard. It's not easy to avoid being angry. It's not easy. But through training, through the remembrance of God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through always reminding ourselves that I'm a guest here and I have to leave. I'm not here forever, so I must leave a good legacy, a good example, a good name. We are all guests in this dunya. All guests. One day, Gabriel comes to Prophet Noah at the end of his term. God tells us in the Quran that Noah served for 950 years. رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا فَلَبِثَ فِي قَوْمِهِ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. He stayed, he served in his community 1,000 years, minus 50. That is 950. This is only the time he served. They say the time he lived was almost 1,700 years. 1,700 years, 1,700 years. So Gabriel comes at the end of his term and he says to him, "Ya أطول الأنبياء عمراً." Oh, the Prophet who served God the most, the longest serving Prophet of God. How did he find this life? He said, "I found it to be very short. I passed it through this life. I found it to be like a house that has two gates. I came from one and I left from the other. I just passed. This life is short, my friends." And I say this to the young generation. Soon, you will get a gray hair like me. One day I was like you, just yesterday. So we have to leave good legacy in this life. Good legacy, good name, good reputation, good examples. Try to stay away from anger. The Prophet said to him three times, "La taghdab, la taghdab, la taghdab." Don't get angry. Sometimes a father, a mother, they get angry with their kids. They put them down. And then they come and wonder, "Why my son is not doing good at school? He's failing." One of the reasons your son is failing is you. The way you put him down. The way you disrespect him. The way you destroy his spirit. You destroy his spirit. Another example of that is when the husband, he chides his wife constantly. He's not happy with her. No matter what she does, he's still not happy. His majesty is not happy. And then he wonders, "Why my wife is not smiling? Why she does not have sense of humor? She's not happy. I don't see her smiling." One of the reasons, because of you. When you speak with her harsh, she's not going to smile. You are destroying her spirit. Another time when we see two brothers, two sisters from one family, from one father, one mother, are constantly fighting each other, quarreling with each other, never knowing that they are going to miss. This is the most important time in their life when they are at home. The siblings, when they live with their parents, that's the golden time. After a few years, they're going to separate. One of them is going to go to the east, the one is going to go to the west. They hardly can see each other. They don't know. They fight and they destroy the beauty of that moment. So God says, always be careful with what you say and how you say. قُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Speak to people in nice and kind way. Be humble when you speak. Be very careful with your tongue. This tongue can make this place and this life the most beautiful, and at the same time, if we go the wrong choice, If we do the wrong choice, the same tongue, the same mouth, the same speech is going to make this life very ugly, very exhausting, very frustrating. Luqman said to his son, "Son, take this sheep, slaughter it, and bring me the best two organs in this sheep." So the son went and he slaughtered the sheep. He came back with the heart and the tongue. He said, "These are the best, the heart and the tongue." So he gave him another sheep. He said to him, "Go on and bring me the worst two organs in this sheep." He slaughtered the sheep. He came back again with the heart and the tongue. He said, "Son, what are you doing?" He said, "Baba, because these two organs are the most important. If they become good, the whole society becomes good. If they become bad, the whole society becomes bad." Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala. Try to encourage people always. Speak nice. Encourage. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, sometimes you cannot attract people through your money because they have money. They themselves are rich. They don't need your money. Maybe they have more money than you. But you can attract them with your akhlaq, with your speech, with your manner, with your temperament, with your humility. Try to encourage. We have an Arab poet by the name of Abu Tayyib al-Mutanabbi, very famous Arab poet, very famous. He says, لا عندك لا خيل عندك تهديها وما ولا مالو فليسعد النطق إن لم يسعد الحال. Sometimes you don't have money to host people at your house. You don't give food. You don't have walima. You don't give gifts. But at least you have another good thing inside you. Speak well. When you speak well, you're going to attract people. Beautify yourself through speaking well. Try to encourage. Try to encourage. Sometimes, believe me, this is a fact. When you speak to someone, he's down, depressed, sad, lost, confused. You just sit with him 5-10 minutes. You revive that person. You resurrect that person. He tells you, he says, "You made my day, subhanAllah," within a few sentences, even if you don't see him. You text him. Simple text, simple phone call, small email, whatever you can. Good gesture of encouragement. Encourage, infuse them with hope. Today the whole world is frustrated, is tired. Look at what is happening. News, 99% of the news are terrible, bad, frightening, intimidating. Many people, they quit the news. They don't watch the news anymore. What do you see in the news? 9 p.m., 10 p.m. news. What do you see? Other than robbing and accidents and fire and theft and bribery and killing and intimidation and refugees. What else do you see? People are tired. But we can infuse them with hope and with peace through our manner. We have a huge capital. That capital is your akhlaq. Your akhlaq and your manners. And this is why we need friends. Why do we come to the Friday prayers? We can do the prayers at home. Nothing special about it. You can do it at home. But God says, إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْءِ. When you hear the adhan of a Friday, leave your work, leave your office, leave your other engagements and rush. فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Why? Because here we meet each other, we inspire each other, we encourage each other, we ask about each other, we help each other, we greet each other. This is what we need today. This is why we need friends. Friends are a source of inspiration for each other. This is why we need family. Why family is important? Why? Just because of the food, biryani? No, it's not only because of the food. There is something more than food, and that is the family cohesion, the support. You find support, you find shelter in your family. So let's go back to what Allah said in the Quran in second chapter. God said it to Bani Israel, but through them to us. Not just to them, to all mankind. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. Speak nice, speak good. Change the style of your speech. Try not to hurt people's feelings. I know sometimes we get angry, frustrated with someone. Be careful. Be careful, because sometimes you say something and you lose that person forever. You lose him forever. We need to bring people to God through the power of speech that we have, the power of conversation, the kalima, kalima tayyiba, God says in the Quran. Beautiful word. Beautiful word. We can bring them back to faith and to God. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal asri innal insana lafi khusrin illa alladhina amanu wa amilu s-salihat. وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره I advise and remind myself first and my sisters and brothers to get hold of God's piety and righteousness. God says in the Quran in chapter number 7, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ونزعنا ما في صدورهم من غل تجري من تحتهم الأنهار وقالوا الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. A man comes to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, O Messenger of God, you know when I offer my prayers, 5 daily prayers, I barely offer 5 daily prayers. I do not do not even one more rak'ah. I don't do nawafil. I don't do extra prayers. I come back tired. I'm busy. I have family to take care of them. So I only do the 5 daily prayers. No more. And when Ramadan comes, I only fast 30 or 29 days. No more. I don't have time, no energy to fast during Rajab, Sha'ban, every Monday, every Thursday, every whatever. And the money I generate barely enough for my family. So I don't pay charity. I don't give donation to Idara Ja'fari. I don't. I have no extra money. I barely take care of my family. I don't have sadaqah. I don't make extra money to pay. And I could not even go to Hajj. I could not tafuq. So do you think God will admit me to His paradise? Do you think? The Prophet puts his head down for a second. Then he raises his head and he smiles. He says, definitely God will take you to paradise. And I promise you come with me to paradise if you promise me to do 6 things. If you promise me, you don't have to do extra prayers, extra fasting, extra charity. These 6 things, try to safeguard them. You come with me, you enter paradise with me. مَعِيَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ with me. He said, what are they, Ya Rasulullah? He said, إِنْ أَنْتَ حَفَظْتَ إِنْ أَنْتَ حَفَظْتَ قَلْبَكَ مِنْ اثْنَتَيْنِ مِنَ الْغِلِّ وَالْحَسَدِ Save your heart from 2 diseases, One of them is hate, hatred, rancor. The second is envy, hasad. Keep your heart clean. Keep it clean. Even if you get into a fight with someone, maybe for a few minutes, few hours, no problem. Couple of days, you get angry at that person, but after that, you have to go back to peace. Don't store the hatred in your heart. The heart is the station of love and affection. Not rancor, not hate. Because you're going to destroy your heart. The first casualty of that hatred is going to be yourself. Yourself. This is number one. Save your heart from ghil. Ghil means hatred. Second, envy. Envy. Wish people goodness. If you see someone in your community purchased a new house, new car, new job, new baby, wish them well. And ask, oh Allah, as you gave him this, give me the same. Wish them. Be always wishing goodness for people. Don't envy them. Don't try to destroy them. So these are the first two things. The second, وَإِنْ أَنْتَ حَفِظْتَمْ لِسَانَكَ مِنْ اثْنَتَيْنِ. Safeguard your tongue from another two diseases. What are they? الْغِيبَةُ وَالْكَذِبُ. Backbiting and lying. Stay away from them. Don't slander people. Don't slander people. Don't gossip. When there is a session, public session, private session, sitting with your friend, with your family, don't gossip about people. We have so many things to speak about. Speak about the weather, mashallah. Lovely weather. Speak about the economy. Speak about soccer. Speak about baseball. Don't talk about people's life. What they have done, their families, their kids, their marriages, their divorces, their daughter-in-law, what is doing to them, don't. Stay away from them. Because we all have our own problems inside our homes, don't we? We have our own challenges. Don't do ghibah. If you have something against someone, say it right in his face. Have the courage of telling him, Mr. Fulan, Haj Fulan, you did something wrong. Don't say it behind him. Don't do that. You are destroying social cohesion. Social cohesion and unity is very important, my friends. Very important. Stay clean. The second thing, don't lie. Why do you lie? Do you need people? We are not surviving on people. We are surviving on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't have to lie. Speak the truth. Keep your honor. How do we become dignified? Not just only through our professions or certificates that we get from universities or our family lineage or a tree or our money or wealth. No. We become honorable and dignified if you act honorably. And one of the things that makes you act honorably, when you don't lie. You don't lie, you speak the truth. Because you don't need people. You really don't need people. Why do you lie? And then he said to him, number five and number six, safeguard your eyes, your vision, min ithnatayn, from two vices, two diseases. One, النظر إلى ما حرم الله. Whatever God has forbidden, don't look at it. Don't, stay away from that. Many things God did not allow us to look at. Private life of people. God says to the community in Surah An-Nur, قل للمؤمنين يغضوا من أبصارهم. Let them cast down their eyes. If women do not want to put on hijab, this is their life. You cannot force them. This is their choice. You control yourself. Don't look. You don't have to look. You don't have to gaze. Many things we should not look into them. Many things. It's not just a matter of hijab. If there is a paper here, your friend is sitting next to you, he has a paper. Respect his privacy. Don't look into his paper. Don't look into his iPhone. Don't look into his computer. Don't. Without permission, don't do these things. Cast down your eyes. This is number one. Number two, the Prophet said to him, and this is very difficult. Number six is very difficult. Safeguard your eyes from looking down at people. Don't give them the dirty look. Don't scorn them with your look. Don't put them down. Don't belittle them. Don't look with an arrogant look. Don't. Stay away from that. respect people. When you look at them, be always courteous and nice, hospitable. So if you safeguard these things, you don't have to worry about extra prayers, extra namaz, namazul layl if you could not do, if you could not do extra fasting, if you could not pay charity, if you could not go to Hajj. These are secondary things. This is the spirit of Islam. These six things are the spirit of Islam, the essence of Islam. These are the akhlaq. And this is why Imam Hussein gave his life. To change the society. To refine the society. To improve the society. The quality of our akhlaq. This is the message of all the Anbiya. Inshallah, through the 10 days and nights of Muharram, we were able to learn, inshallah, and these ideas would sink in, and inshallah, we change ourselves first, and then we go and change the people around us, inshallah. And thank you, alhamdulillah, thank you for having a successful Muharram. Still, the pandemic is there, but alhamdulillah, all of you have observed the health protocol, which is something very good, very civilized. This is the picture that we have to send about the Muslims in this country and elsewhere, that we care about our lives and the lives of others. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, Idara Ja'fariya is one of the most progressive communities, alhamdulillah. You have good building, good boards, good congregation and good programs, alhamdulillah. And Allah will be always with you, protecting you, inshallah ta'ala. Allahumma akhfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat الأحياء منهم والأموات تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات إنك مجيب الدعوات إنك غافر الخطيئات إنك ماحي السيئات وجاعلها حسنات إنك على كل شيء قدير وعجل اللهم في فرج قائدنا وسيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد